beautiful daughters, a business owner, and a dedicated Republican. I made the commitment to the Republican Party because of its core values of patriotism, individual freedom, and fiscal conservatism, the same values that matter to me, and they're the same values I learned as an Eagle Scout. And they're the same values I try to teach my daughters. Now you've heard a lot of political rhetoric and promises, but I'd like to talk to you about what I've actually done. Because it's not enough just to talk about values. What matters is how you apply your guiding principles to what you do every day. Anybody can talk. Taking action is what really counts. For example, 4 years ago, the legislature decided to link the gas tax to inflation, so it would automatically increase every year. Not only was it the biggest tax increase in our state's history, but it was also taxation without representation. Sound familiar? Imagine that. Massachusetts, the home of the Revolutionary War, was about to let greedy Beacon Hill politicians turn back the clock to taxation without representation to grab your money and fund continued wasteful spending. Well, I stood up and said, not on my watch. Automatic gas tax, like saving the taxpayers over $2 billion.
Alrighty!
And 3 years ago, when Bob Patrick and Elizabeth Warren got excited about bringing the Olympics to Massachusetts in 2024, never considering the financial consequences, we vowed to do another ballot question to protect the taxpayers. And I was told this is political suicide. However, the people of my district who voted for me did not send me to the State House to keep quiet. They sent me there to fight for them, and that's exactly what I did.
All right! Woo!
That effort saved Massachusetts taxpayers as much as $10 billion. The fiscal watchdog group, Citizens for Limited Taxation, they recognized my commitment and gave me a perfect rating. Legislators to vote against a state budget that contained a loophole that allowed illegal immigrants to get driver's licenses. And when the Speaker of the House decided he wanted to be Speaker for life, I filed a legislation to restore term limits.
All right.
You know, Eagle Scouts will always say, leave the campground better than you found it. Whether it's fighting the gas tax, or blocking the Olympics from emptying your pockets, I've always been willing to stand up for you. And as your next United States Senator, my door will always be open. I will be by your side, and we will work together on what matters to most to you and to your family. Now, can you say that same thing about our current Senator? I mean, where has she been? It's clear where she hasn't been. She hasn't been stopping illegal immigration or securing our borders. She hasn't been fighting for taxpayers or cutting spending in Washington. And she certainly hasn't been doing anything to grow jobs back here at home. So, where has the Senator been for the last 6 years? I'll tell you where. Everywhere but Massachusetts. She's been writing and selling books, flying all over the country, visiting states that seem to matter more to her, raising money for Democratic candidates, and building her national profile to run for president. From the moment she got elected, Warren put Massachusetts in the rearview mirror, and she never looked back. Well, that's not me. I will never forget the people who sent me to Washington. I will spend every day, from the time I get up in the morning until the time I put my head on the pillow, fighting for you. Safer, stronger, and more prosperous, and to put Massachusetts back on the front burner. We deserve a United States Senator we can trust. A Senator who understands that job one is to stand up for our state and defend the principles we care about. We need a Senator who puts on the gloves, gets in the ring, fights all 15 rounds for Massachusetts. And we also need a Senator who will stop pointing fingers and listen to us and not lecture us. Yeah! chart a new and a positive course for Massachusetts. Whether it's advocating for fishermen from Gloucester to New Bedford, or helping all our veterans from Holyoke to Chelsea access quality health care, or protecting Massachusetts business owners from restrictive regulations, our next senator must put Massachusetts first. And I promise you, I will be here to assist and not to resist. Now, this won't be easy. The media, the expert pundits, the special interest groups, and of course the agenda-driven liberals, they all want you to believe Warren can't lose. Well, let's think about that for a minute. She represents a very blue state. She's got so much money in her war chest. She's gathered lobbyists and special interest groups to have her back. Well, and the media certainly is on her side. But you know what? She can keep all of that. Because I have something better. I have you. And our pleasure to do the work, because that's how we're going to win. That's how we're going to beat Warren in November. You know, successful people would say, vision is important, but doing the hard work is what really matters. And by the way, a certain Super Bowl coach once said, winning happens when commitment, preparation, and leadership all come together. Well, that's our plan. That's our blueprint. And we're going to lay it all on the line together. We gain nothing from being timid or weak, and we gain everything by being passionate about our principles and our process. Historically, great leaders like Adams, Lincoln, Churchill, Reagan, they've all proved that our greatest gains come when we stand together and refuse to go quietly into that dark night. My friends, this is our moment, this is our opportunity, this is our time to turn the tide. Let's stand together and defend the future of our nation, of our state, and of our children. The stakes are high, but our goals are even higher. To defeat a liberal agenda that threatens to infect us with stifling taxes, disastrous government-run healthcare, and failed foreign policies that invigorate our enemies, today you have a choice. With whom will you enter this battle? I ask you to stand with me. Together we will take this fight to every corner of the Commonwealth, to every city and town.